This month's Japanese history focuses on the Meiji Restoration, as we did last time. The Meiji Restoration was a movement against the shogunate and modernization reforms that took place at the end of the Edo period. This revolution made Japan one of the few countries that did not become a colony of the Western powers, and had a strong influence on the rest of Asia. Previously, I talked about the developments of the Satsuma and Choshu clans before the Sacho Alliance. This time, I would like to talk about the Tosa clan, which was active in the latter half of the Meiji Restoration. Ryoma Sakamoto was born in the Tosa clan. It was Ryotaro Shiba's Ryoma Gayuku that made his name famous. It is a very interesting novel that explains the Meiji Restoration in a very simple way. If you are interested in reading it, I highly recommend it. As I mentioned before, the Satsuma and Choshu clans were foreign feudal lords who followed the Tokugawa after Sekigahara. The Satsuma clan and the Choshu clan were not relieved of their territories, but rather had their territories cut off, and were clans with little loyalty to the Tokugawa. The first lord of the Tosa clan, Kazutoyo Yamauchi, was a warlord who was indebted to Hideyoshi Toyotomi. However, when the generals of the Toyotomi clan who had left their families in Kyoto could not make up their minds when they heard of Ishida Mitsunari's raising of troops, which triggered the Battle of Sekigahara, he was the first to announce that he would join Ieyasu Tokugawa, and the other generals followed suit and became allies. In recognition of this achievement, Kazutoyo Yamauchi was given the country of Tosa. Therefore, the Tosa clan, unlike the Satsuma and Choshu clans, was indebted to the Tokugawa shogunate. The Tosa clan had a different situation regarding the rank of samurai than the Satsuma and Choshu clans. There were two classes of samurai. The first was the samurai who came to Tosa after the Battle of Sekigahara, following the orders of the sovereign Yamauchi Kazutoyo. These were the samurai who owed a debt of gratitude to the sovereign, and were called Joshi, and were given preferential treatment by the sovereign. The other is a samurai who originally lived in his hometown of Tosa for a long time and served the Chosokabe clan, whose territory was confiscated during the Battle of Sekigahara. During the Edo period, there were many samurai who supported themselves by farming, and were called Goshi, or samurai who were treated coldly by the monarch. It was these samurai who led the movement to expel the barbarians from Tosa. At the end of the Edo period, Tosa's activities began with the involvement of the feudal lord Yodo Yamauchi in the administration of the shogunate. Together with Narayakira Shimazu of Satsuma, Yodo was a supporter of the theory of the unification of government and military, and supported a political system that included the imperial court and powerful feudal lords. In the battle to determine the next shogun, he favored Yoshinobu Hitotsubashi, but was defeated in a political dispute with the grand elder Naosuke II. After that, Yodo was placed under house arrest during the Ansei no Daigaku by Naosuke II. The clan was controlled by Yodo and his close advisor Toyo Yoshida. II's oppressive regime created many enemies, and he was assassinated in the Sakuradamon incident. This assassination had a tremendous impact on all of Japan, and gave people confidence that even a lowly samurai could change Japan. As a result, the expulsion of the barbarians movement gained momentum throughout Japan. Tosa was no exception. In Tosa, a group called the Tosukino Party was born, led by Zuozen Rikichi. Most of the members of this group were low-ranking samurai called Goshi. The leader of the party, Zuozen Rikichi, had the status of a low-ranking samurai, but a slightly higher one. He was a young man with excellent swordsmanship, character, and popularity. Ryoma Sakamoto was also a member of the Tosukino Party. Rikichi walked all over Japan and befriended influential people in various parts of the country. Then, along with the feudal lords of Choshu and Satsuma, he gathered a group of soldiers from Tosa to go to Kyoto and pledged to expel the barbarians. However, Yodo and Toyo Yoshida, who were both advocates of the union of the military and public, knew that it was impossible to break off relations with foreign countries, and rejected Takechi's request. When information came in that both the Satsuma and Choshu clans were going to Kyoto with their lords, Takechi became impatient. Ryoma Sakamoto gave up on the Tosa clan, broke away from the clan, and moved to Kyoto to act alone. Takechi insisted that the clan expel the barbarians. He therefore planned to assassinate Toyo Yoshida, who was still in control of the clan and opposed to expulsion. This assassination was successful because Toyo, who had risen through the ranks by forceful methods, had many enemies. Takeshi gave his puppet the power to control the actions of the clan. Yodo hates Takeshi for the murder of his confidant, but now that the times are bad, he suppresses his desire for revenge against Takeki and lets him go. Takeshi worked with the Imperial Court to invite the Lord of the Tosa clan to Kyoto, and he himself left for Kyoto as an attendant. This was the peak of Takeshi's career. In Kyoto, Takeshi drafted opinions to the Imperial Court through the feudal lords. It seems that Takeki wanted to restore the monarchy with the emperor at the center. In addition, assassinations of opponents by pro-exclusionist samurai were rampant in Kyoto, and Takeshi was involved. When Yodo returned to Tosa in March 1863, he began to search for the murderer of Toyo Yoshida. He also dismissed the retainers who had been acting as puppets for Takeshi one after another, and clamped down on the Tosa Kino party. Takeshi decided to return to Tosa to pacify Yodo. Takeshi's supporters in Kyoto urged him to flee to Choshu because of the danger, but he still had hope for Yodo. He had no idea that Yodo was bent on revenge for Toyo's murder. One by one, the members of the Tosa Kino party were captured, but Yodo proceeded cautiously with the leader, Takeshi. Yodo then arrested Takeshi just as the expulsionists were losing momentum after Choshu was ousted from power in Kyoto in a political upheaval on August 18. Takeshi was not tortured because of his high status, but his comrades were severely tortured. His involvement in the assassination in Kyoto came to light one after another. Even so, the comrades of the Workers' Party never spoke out about Takeshi's involvement in the murder of Toyo. However, Takeshi was ordered by Yodo to commit seppuku. Most of his comrades, who were lower-ranked samurai, could not defend their honor as samurai by beheading. When he committed seppuku, he slit his own belly three times and was stabbed in the heart by an aide when he was lying on his stomach. With the loss of Takeshi, the leader of the Tosa Kino party, the Tosa Kino party was effectively destroyed. The Tosa clan, which had played a role in the Meiji Restoration, would have to lay low for a while. Then, with the rise of Ryoma Sakamoto, the Tosa clan, relying on Ryoma's connections, would once again appear on the curtain of history. I'll explain it again in the next article. Please subscribe to our channel and click the like button if you like.